Hey guys, welcome to TexConnect, a learning center for textiles. First of all, thank you to all our subscribers for helping us reach this milestone of 2000 subscribers. It is just y'all who motivate us to make these kind of videos. And if you still have not subscribed to our channel, then please subscribe so that it motivates us and we continue making such kind of videos. So now let us start with today's topic, that is carding. We have seen carding up to liquorin. And now let us see what we have further. So as y'all can see, this is a diagram of a carding machine, and here I have marked the cylinder and the flats. So we will start with the main carding region, that is this cylinder and the flats. Together, these both parts form the main carding zone, where the most important function of the carding machine, that is fiber to fiber separation or fiber individualization, takes place. So let us see these both the parts in detail. The cylinder. As the name suggests, it is a cylinder having a diameter of approximately 130 centimeters. It is made out of cast iron or steel, and the modern cylinders are fully enclosed in metal sheets, and they have some traverse slots which are provided to remove the impurities and also maintain a constant airflow. However, the cleaning effect on cylinders is pretty less. The main cleaning has already been done on the liquorin. So there were waste eliminating parts that were provided in the liquorin region, and that is where the main cleaning effect takes place. Therefore, keeping this in mind, many manufacturers have now opted for fully enclosed metal sheets. These fully enclosed metal sheets prevent the small air vortex that used to arise near the slots. So this helps in better fiber orientation with lesser nibs on high speed carding machines. And the entire surface of the cylinder is covered with fine metal needles or pin clothing for the carding process. Now let us move on to the flats. These are bars made out of cast iron and have an inverted T-shaped cross section. The lower surface of these flats is smooth and contains some wire points. So these flats, they rest on adjustable or flexible bends to the left hand side and the right hand side of the cylinder, and then they have to slide on these guide surfaces. So in short, as you all can see in the diagram, they move on top of the cylinder surface, and here between the fiber surface and the cylinder surface, the main carding action takes place. So these flats are somewhat longer than the operating width of the card. And as you all can see in the diagram, these are some of the modern flats that are available in the market. So this is for just for representation, so you all can better understand. And also, diagrammatically, it is represented. Now let us move to the next slide. So together, the cylinder and the flats form the main carding zone. As you all can see in the image besides, the cylinder is moving in the clockwise direction, that is in the material flow direction, and the flats which are above the cylinder are moving in the opposite direction, that is anti-clockwise direction. So together, these both actions, they have the following effects, like the following effects are achieved. The first is fiber to fiber separation. So when the material is moving with the cylinder, like when the material is flowing ahead with the cylinder and the flats are moving in the opposite direction, both the clothing, like the clothing of the cylinder and the clothing of the flats, they are in the carding configuration. So we had studied about the carding and the doffing configuration in the part 2 of the carding series. So here both have carding configuration, and when these flats brush over the cylinder surface, the fibers get combed out. So the main action is combing out. And during this combing out action, the fibers get individualized, like that is fiber to fiber gets separated. When we comb out the fringe, the fibers get separated, and this is the main carding function, that is fiber to fiber separation. Now next is elimination of impurities. So as we know that the major impurities are eliminated in the liquorin region itself, like we have the waste removing elements over there, and the major elimination part is done over there. But however, there may be some impurities that are adhered to the fiber and which are difficult to remove on the Likerin region. So these impurities, they get eliminated here in the carding zone. When the fibers get separated or individualized, it is easy to remove these impurities. Some impurities also get pressed into the flat clothing and may be then eliminated as flat strippings. Or during the carding process, the impurities may fall off, and then due to the continuous airflow and the vacuum, they may get eliminated with the slots that are presented. The next is elimination of short fibers. So elimination of short fibers is not one of the main functions of a carding machine. But however, during this carding process, the longer fibers which have more surface area tend to move with the cylinder and stick to the cylinder surface. And the short fibers provide less surface area and are often pressed into the flat clothing. And after every cycle, the flats are cleaned, and therefore these fibers that get stuck into the flat clothing have to leave the machine as flat strippings. The waste that is removed from the flats is known as flat strippings. So unfortunately, some of these short fibers are removed as flat strippings. However, the ratio is very small, but this is also a good fiber loss which is occurring. The next function is untangling nebs. So when the fibers are getting separated or the fiber to fiber separation takes place, the nebs are also opened out. So it is always a false consideration that the nebs are eliminated as waste or they are eliminated with the flat strippings. However, most of the nebs are opened out in this zone. In the carding process, most of the nebs are opened out. Only a few, very few of the nebs are removed as flat strippings. So untangling nebs is one of the functions of the carding machine. The next function is dust removal. So this dust is adhered to the fiber surface, and the removal takes place either by fiber to fiber friction or fiber to metal friction. And both of these can be achieved here on the carding machine. The fibers also get individualized, like in the carding zone, they are in the individual state, and therefore the removal of dust is easier. The next is longitudinal orientation. So on the cylinder surface, a temporary longitudinal orientation is obtained. The cylinder and the flats, they comb out the material, giving this temporary longitudinal orientation. So I say temporary because the fibers are individualized and have no cohesion, and to transport these fibers ahead, there needs to be some cohesion in the material, right? And hence this orientation which was obtained here disappears further, because we need cohesion further. Now next, let's move on to the next slide. So as we know, the flats are moving, so a continuous carding surface needs to be made, and this is made by securing a large number of flats on a continuous or a rotating chain or a belt. So around 100 to 120 flats are there in total on the carding machine. But on a given movement, there are only 40 to 45 which are operating or which are in contact with the cylinder surface at a given time. So why do we need this rotation of flats? As we know that there was some phenomenon as flat strippings, like the flats used to get accumulated with the fiber waste or the impurities. So as the waste is eliminated by filling of these flats, the flats get filled and they lose the efficiency of combing out or performing the carding action, and so they need to be cleaned. And this is the reason why after every cycle the flats are cleaned. So after every rotation there is a cleaning assembly that is there which cleans the flat, and this is why they keep on continuously rotating, so that after the carding action takes place, they go into the cleaning assembly, the flats are cleaned, and the cycle repeats again. So this is how the entire chain is working. Also, as you all can see over here in the diagram, that the flats are moving over the cylinder, and they have a slight tilt. That is, if I see in the material flow direction, the leading edge is spaced a little further from the cylinder than the trailing edge. So this is done so that when the flats are moving, the fibers are not pushed along in front of the flats. Instead, the fibers can pass underneath the flats and carding can take place smoothly. So this is why a continuous carding surface is provided, so that the waste can be eliminated by the cleaning action, and total of around 100 to 120 flats are there on a carding machine. Now let us move on to the next slide. So up till now we have seen the main carding region, that was the region between the cylinder and the flats. Now let us move on to the sliver and the web forming region. This region consists of a doffer, a stripping device, a condenser and a calendar roller. And also after that a sliver is formed and it gets collected into a sliver can. So here I have marked a doffer, a stripping device and a calendar roller. This is the diagram of a carding machine. So we have studied about the liquorin which is there. We have studied about the flats, the cylinder. Now moving further, we have the doffer, stripping device and the calendar roller. So up till this region, we have all the fibers that are separated. The individual fibers are separated and are longitudinally oriented on the cylinder surface. However, these fibers are not interlocked and they also lack cohesiveness. So these fibers do not have any entanglement or cohesiveness in between them and cannot be transferred further. Because for further transport, there needs to be some cohesion which holds the fibers together. So this cohesion is given by the doffer. So let us see exactly what does the doffer do. Firstly, a doffer is a drum made out of cast iron or steel and has a diameter of about 60 to 70 centimeters. It is designed in such a way that it can collect the individual fibers from the cylinder surface and condense them to form a web. So this web is a very thin sheet or a thin delicate sheet of fibers. In the image you all can see a web on the carding machine. So this doffer has a speed of about 300 meters to minute or about 150 to 160 rpm. So compared to the cylinder, the doffer runs at a very low speed, very slow speed. So due to this, what happens is when the fibers are on the cylinder surface, so these fibers are moving at a faster speed, like with the cylinder they are moving, so it moves on a faster speed. And as these fibers fall onto the surface of the doffer, which is moving onto a very low speed, so what happens is due to this difference in the speeds, fiber buckling takes place. That is, the fibers tend to bend, creating hooks. So but this phenomenon also helps in cohesion. These hooks are not needed, but they help in cohesion, and these hooks are then removed in the subsequent processes. Now let us have a look at this doffing operation. Or doffing operation is also known as creating a web from the individual fibers. So collecting the individual fibers from the cylinder surface and doffing it to form a web. So we had studied about the carding and the doffing disposition in the second part of this series. So you all must be wondering that for the transfer of fibers, we will require doffing configuration. But no, here the cylinder and the doffer are arranged in a carding configuration. You all must be wondering why. This is because the configuration, the carding configuration, helps in interlacing of the fibers. So this improves the cohesion, like the web that we need, the web that has to be delivered has to be cohesive and it has to be condensed. So this is the reason why carding configuration is used between a doffer and a cylinder. Also, for smooth and efficient transfer of fibers from the cylinder surface to the doffer surface, the distance between them should be very small. Mostly it is less than 0.2 mm. And many a times it is also less than 0.1 mm. Here in the diagram, y'all can see the carding configuration that is present between the cylinder and the flats. These arrows represent the speed. So as seen over here, the cylinder moves very fast compared to the doffer. Now let us move on to the next slide. The disadvantages of carding configuration compared to the doffing configuration. And let us see how these disadvantages are used to our advantage. As I said earlier, that a temporary longitudinal orientation is achieved on the cylinder. All the fibers are individualized on the cylinder surface. However, this longitudinal orientation disappears on the doffer and we get a random orientation. But this disadvantage is used for our advantage, as this random orientation is used for creating the web. So one of the other major disadvantages is the fiber buckling or bending of the fibers that created hooks in the fiber. So this is also used as an advantage, because creating of the hooks helps in the fiber cohesion and creating the web, and these hooks are further then removed in the subsequent spinning operations. But for a cohesion, this doffing operation is very necessary. And the third disadvantage is poor transfer of fibers from cylinder to doffer. Now this disadvantage is also more of an advantage, as the material rotates many a times before moving on to the doffer surface. So it will rotate for many times on the cylinder surface itself, and providing extra carding points and extra cleaning. So this is also an advantage for us. Now let us move on to the next slide. So on the cylinder surface, we had individual fibers, which on the doffer, we doffed them, we condensed them and formed a web. Now we have a web from the doffer, which needs to be taken ahead and needs to be condensed to form a sliver. The sliver is the end package of the carding machine. So it is a thick strand of the fibers. And if you all have seen the carding introduction video or the introduction to spinning overview video, you all must be knowing what is a sliver. So on the conventional old cards, a fly comb was used for collecting the web ahead from the doffer. Fly comb was a comb that used to oscillate at around 2500 strokes per minute. So with each stroke, it used to collect the web ahead. But in the high speed carding machines, using this fly comb is not possible, as many strokes would be required per minute and the amount would be larger or more than the mechanical limit. So a roller is used instead of the fly comb. As you all can see in the image, nowadays a roller is used to take the web, to collect the web from the doffer. So after collecting the web from the doffer, it needs to be condensed to form a sliver. Here, the image on the bottom right, y'all can see what is condensation of the sliver. So the web is being condensed to form a sliver. So it is a modern carding machine, as the detaching rollers are used instead of flying comb. So the rollers that were used on the carding machine for collecting the web ahead are known as detaching rollers. And y'all can see over here that detaching rollers are used for collecting the web, and then it is being condensed to form a sliver. So on the old cards, the web would be freely suspended over a length of around 30 to 50 centimeters, and then it would pass through a funnel where the condensation would happen. So in the image, y'all can see on the bottom left, that shows an old card where we can see the web is freely suspended over a 30 to 50 centimeters of length. So this suspending the web is also not possible on modern high-speed carding machines, as the web would fall apart if suspended over such a length on such high speeds. So this is the reason why nowadays the web condensation that is done takes place inside the detaching zone itself. So on the next slide, we can see that the web nowadays is condensed into sliver while it is still in the detaching zone. So in the diagram also, it is seen that the condensation that is happening in the detaching zone itself. So it is mostly nowadays carried out by two counter rotating belts that carry the web to the center, or one rotating belt that carries the web to one side of the card. And many manufacturers are also using rollers instead of the belts. So now we also have the sliver with us. So moving on to the next slide, here I have put some images of a modern carding machine. After forming the sliver, it is coiled in sliver cans. Y'all can see how huge the sliver cans are, and for these high speed carding machines. Also, in these modern carding machines, the cans are automatically replaced with empty cans after it gets filled. And this brings us to an end of the carding process. So it is very difficult to explain everything in four parts. So to complete the entire carding process in four parts, it is a very detailed topic. So, but we have tried to include everything that was possible. Please refer to books for more details, like books will give you the best knowledge. And these videos are just for revision and for a better understanding of the topic. So if you all have found this video to be helpful, please like this video, share it with all the textile people you know, and please comment down below if you all have any doubts. And for more such textile related content, please do follow and please subscribe to TextConnect, a learning center for textiles. Thank you very much.